It was a hot day. The sun was shining brightly, and not a cloud was to be seen in the sky. Looby Loo thought it would be nice to have something cool to drink, so she, Andy Pandy and Teddy were going to make lemonade. On the table were a jug, some sugar, a lemon squeezer, and four big yellow lemons. Teddy thought it might be fun to do some juggling with the lemons. Looby Loo didn't. She didn't want anything in her cozy little house getting broken. Teddy wanted to cut the lemons in half. Looby Loo told him that the knife was quite sharp, and if it slipped, he might hurt himself. So she asked Andy Pandy to cut them instead. Next, Looby Loo had to melt some sugar in water to sweeten the lemonade. She poured the sugar into her saucepan. Then she added a little water. Teddy wanted to help. Looby Loo told Teddy that the pan was getting very hot and he might burn himself. Teddy was beginning to wonder what he was going to be able to do to help make the lemonade. Andy Pandy asked Teddy if he'd like to squeeze the lemons. At last, Teddy was going to do something. He squeezed and squeezed the lemons. Soon, he'd squeezed all four lemons, and he poured their juice into the jug. By that time, Looby Loo had melted the sugar in the water. She poured that into the jug, too. The lemonade felt quite hot. Ow. Teddy thought lemonade was supposed to be cool and refreshing, but Looby Loo said they hadn't quite finished yet. She gave the lemonade a good stir. Andy Pandy added some ice. The lemonade was good and cold now. It was ready to drink. Looby Loo even had some straws to drink it with. It tasted delicious. When Teddy had finished his lemonade, he made a lot of noise with his straws. Looby Loo said she thought he was being a bit rude. She asked him to stop, so he did. But Teddy was feeling mischievous. He used his straw to blow in Looby Loo's ear. Looby Loo wasn't pleased. She didn't like having tricks played on her. Then Andy Pandy said he knew of something else you could do with straws. Something a bit more useful and a bit less likely to get a Teddy into trouble. Back at Andy Pandy's house, Andy Pandy was looking in his cupboard. He found some sheets of paper and some pots of paint. Andy Pandy asked Teddy which colour he'd like to use first. Teddy thought Andy Pandy had forgotten something. Where were the paintbrushes? Andy Pandy said they didn't need paintbrushes, they were going to use straws. Straws? A straw wouldn't make a very good paintbrush at all. But Teddy was wrong. And as Andy Pandy blew on the paint, Teddy saw that it made lovely red shapes on the paper. Now he wanted a turn. Teddy blew the paint with a straw, and soon he'd made some lovely patterns too. Andy Pandy and Teddy blew and blew, and then they blew some more. They'd soon covered the paper with long, wiggly lines of paint. Teddy had quite a bit on him too. They'd made a lovely painting, and Andy Pandy said they could do another one. Later that day, Andy Pandy invited everyone to his house to see the paintings he and Teddy had done. Everyone thought they were brilliant, and Looby Loo had made some more lemonade. They thought that was brilliant too. Everyone enjoyed the lemonade, and Looby Loo didn't even mind when Teddy made rude noises in his glass again.
Andy Pandy Land.
It had been a very hot night, and the heat had kept Andy Pandy awake. Teddy hadn't slept well either. Andy was telling Bilbo how hard it was to sleep during a hot night, and Bilbo said that Andy and Teddy should make a tent so they could sleep in the fresh air. All they'd need was an old sheet and a clothesline. Andy thought that Looby Lou might have some old sheets. Looby soon found an old sheet for Andy and Teddy. Then Looby found a clothesline and she lent that to Andy and Teddy as well. Looby sent Andy and Teddy off to Bilbo's so he could teach them how to make their tent. Bilbo told Andy and Teddy to tie one end of Looby's clothesline to the tree and the other end to the top of the slide. Andy and Teddy hung the sheet over the clothesline. Andy put pebbles on the side of the sheet to hold the tent in place. And then the tent was ready. Soon it would be time to try it out. That night, Teddy lit the way as Looby helped Andy Pandy carry everything that they would need for a night in their new tent. Teddy fell asleep and dropped his torch, and it suddenly got very dark. But the moon came out, and again they could see what they were doing. Looby and Bilbo said goodnight to Andy and Teddy. Andy and Teddy were eating biscuits for their supper. Teddy wanted one last biscuit, but fell asleep before he could eat it. So Andy finished Teddy's biscuit, and then he also fell asleep. Tiffo had been for a long walk, and he hadn't seen the tent that Andy Pandy and Teddy had made. He wondered what this strange new white thing could be, and barked to make it go away. When Andy Pandy told Tiffo what the tent was for, he decided to leave it where it was. Andy and Teddy were soon asleep again, but the wind had started to blow, and the night got much colder. The wind blew harder and harder. As the tent blew away, Andy and Teddy thought that it didn't feel like a cozy tent anymore, and they wanted to go home to their own beds. Andy and Teddy thought they'd seen a horrid white giant, and they ran home as fast as they could. They didn't even stop to pick up their blankets. Next day was dull and chilly. Looby Lou thought Andy and Teddy would like a warm, sweet drink after their night in the tent. But where had the tent gone? And where were Andy and Teddy? And what was that strange noise? It was Missy Hissy. Looby soon saw that her old sheet had trapped Missy Hissy inside her house. Andy and Teddy must have gone home, but Looby was sure they'd come and help Missy Hissy. As soon as she could see out of her window, Missy Hissy thanked her friends for rescuing her. After being trapped by a tent, there was nothing Missy Hissy would like more than a mug of Looby's warm, sweet drink. Looby Lou was right. After such a strange night, everyone wanted a mug of her warm, sweet drink. The drink made Teddy feel so cozy. He was soon very sleepy again and fell asleep.
Teddy too, playing in the garden every day.
Early one morning, Teddy was up and about and off to visit his best friend, Andy Pandy. It was early in the morning and Andy Pandy hadn't finished his breakfast. He was having a boiled egg. He asked Teddy if he'd like one too. Teddy said he'd already had his breakfast, wasn't very fond of eggs. Andy Pandy said he bet he knew one sort of egg that Teddy liked. Chocolate eggs. Chocolate eggs were Teddy's favourite. Where were they, he wondered. Andy Pandy said he hadn't got any. But maybe they could make some. Andy Pandy looked in his special cupboard and found some bars of chocolate and some egg-shaped moulds. He said they'd go to Looby Lou's house and make the chocolate eggs there. Looby Lou was happy to lend Andy Pandy and Teddy a saucepan and let them use her little cooker. They broke the chocolate into pieces and put them into the saucepan. Then Andy Pandy began to melt the chocolate. Teddy wanted a go at stirring the chocolate mixture, but Looby Lou said that it was getting very hot. Teddy might burn himself. Soon, the chocolate was melted. Very carefully, Andy Pandy poured the chocolate into the moulds. Teddy said he wanted the first egg. Wait, Teddy. The chocolate has to cool down and go hard before there are any chocolate eggs. So Teddy waited and waited and waited. When Teddy woke up, the chocolate moulds had gone. Where were they? And what about the chocolate eggs? Andy Pandy had taken the moulds home. And as for the eggs, said Looby Lou, she and Andy Pandy had wrapped them up in coloured foil and hidden them about the garden. They thought Teddy would like to have an egg hunt. Teddy thought that sounded like a brilliant idea. Andy Pandy told Teddy not to eat all the eggs at once. He'd get tummy ache. Teddy was off and looking for chocolate eggs as quick as you like. Tiffo had found one of the eggs Andy Pandy and Looby Lou had hidden, only he didn't know what it was. He thought it was a game. Teddy said it wasn't a game. It was a chocolate egg. Teddy ate it all up. Poor Tiffo didn't get any, and naughty Teddy didn't even pick up the wrapper. Teddy scampered off to find more chocolate eggs. Meanwhile, Bilbo had found something at the front of his boat. He wondered what it was. He quickly found out when Teddy arrived. Bilbo thought the chocolate egg looked rather tasty. But soon it had all gone, except for the wrapper, naughty Teddy. Orby had discovered a round purple thing near his house. He thought it might be one of his relatives come to pay him a visit, but it wasn't saying much. Teddy said that was because it was a chocolate egg. Chocolate eggs never said very much, but they did taste yummy once you got rid of the wrapper. There was a blue thing sitting on Missy Hissy's pipes. It was a chocolate egg. Missy Hissy thought she might have liked a piece of chocolate egg. She didn't want the wrapper, though. At last, Teddy returned to Looby Lou's house. Andy Pandy asked if Teddy had found all the eggs. So, where were they? Asked Looby Lou. Teddy had eaten them all. And now, he wasn't feeling very well. Then the others arrived. They had brought with them the wrappers that Teddy had thrown away. They told Teddy what a bad bear he was to leave sweet wrappers all over the place. Looby Lou was very cross when she heard Teddy had been dropping litter. Teddy felt worse than ever. The others asked whether there were any more chocolate eggs. Andy Pandy had to tell them that there weren't. But he could soon make some more. Enough for everyone. For everyone except me, said Teddy. He wasn't going to want any chocolate for quite a while. It was a hot day. The sun was shining brightly and not a cloud was to be seen in the sky. Handy Pandy hadn't come out to play all day long. And Looby Loo and Teddy both wondered what had happened to him. They agreed to knock very gently on Andy's door to see if he was in. Looby wanted to know who had sneezed. Andy Pandy had caught a nasty cold. Looby thought Andy should have a warm drink and promised to bring him some hot lemon juice from her own house. Looby told Teddy about Andy's cold and said they should make a scarf to keep him warm. Teddy said he'd like to make the scarf. Soon he was hard at work making Andy's scarf. Looby Loo had lent him some knitting needles and a ball of wool. But Teddy had never used knitting needles before and was finding it very difficult indeed. Tiffo was looking for someone to play with, then suddenly spotted the ball of wool. The ball of wool was the best toy Tiffo had ever played with. Bilbo had heard Andy's sneezes and wanted to visit him, but he couldn't get past all the wool. Missy Hissy was going to visit Andy too, and she could slither through the wool. Bilbo stayed behind and tidied up the green. Andy was feeling a bit better after his sleep. Teddy was proud of the very first woolen scarf he'd ever made, but he didn't want to catch Andy's cold, so he was pleased when Looby asked him to fetch some honey for Andy's warm drink. Even though Teddy had tried hard, the scarf really wasn't very good. But Missy Hissy said she'd keep Andy warm. Now that Teddy had brought the jar of honey, Looby Loo could make Andy's warm drink. And Missy Hissy promised to make sure he drank it. Next morning, Looby Loo and Teddy went to see if Andy Pandy was feeling better. And they were pleased to see he was feeling much better. He hadn't sneezed all night, and Missy Hissy had already gone home. In fact, Andy was ready to come out to play. Andy felt so much better, he wanted to have a swing. Oh, poor Missy Hissy had caught Andy Pandy's cold. Andy knew how to make her feel better. Andy gave Missy Hissy some of his warm lemon and honey drink. Bilbo had spent all night knitting a scarf. He had made it for Andy Pandy, but the scarf fitted Missy Hissy just as well, and she was feeling better already. was a beautiful spring morning, and Andy Pandy had decided to plant some flowers to make his garden look even prettier than it already was. Teddy and Tiffo were playing a game. The game could have been chase the teddy or catch the dog. Neither of them was quite sure. But when they saw Andy Pandy, they stopped playing. Teddy asked Andy what he was doing. Andy told them that he was planting flowers. Teddy wanted to help. Andy Pandy said he could. But if he was going to help, said Andy Pandy, he'd need a trowel to dig holes for the flowers to go into. So he went inside to fetch one. Teddy went to smell Andy Pandy's new flowers, and as he did, he saw something that he didn't like at all. When Andy Pandy heard all the fuss, he came out of his house very quickly indeed and asked Teddy what was the matter. Teddy pointed down to the flower bed. Teddy had seen a beetle, a rather small beetle. A small and not really very frightening beetle. But it had frightened Teddy all right, with its creepy little legs and wiggly little feelers and its big, buggy eyes. Missy Hissy thought Teddy was being very silly indeed. Fancy being frightened of a teeny-weeny beetle. Missy Hissy laughed as she carried on her way. Andy Pandy asked Teddy if he still wanted to do some gardening. Teddy said he didn't know that bones were used for planting flowers. Andy laughed at his mistake. He'd brought the bone for Tiffo. No, you use trowels for gardening. But Teddy said that the beetle had rather put him off gardening. Andy Pandy said they'd do something else instead. He said they were going to do something else with beetles. Not real beetles, said Andy Pandy. They were going to make beetle masks. In his special cupboard, Andy Pandy found some card, some poster paints, some brushes, a pair of scissors, and some red ribbon. Next, Andy Pandy folded one of the pieces of card in half and painted a big blob, some swooshes, and swirls. Then, as Teddy watched with great interest, Andy Pandy folded the card in half again. When he opened the card out, Teddy was amazed. It looked like a very colourful beetle's head. Teddy watched as Andy Pandy cut out the mask. Then he made holes so that he could see through the mask, and two more holes for the ribbon. He threaded the ribbon through them. Teddy wasn't scared of this beetle. Now Teddy wanted to make his own beetle mask, and with Andy Pandy's help, he did. Now Teddy looked like a beetle too. They crept and they crawled, they scuttled and scampered, two of the biggest beetles you've ever seen. Then Teddy had an idea. He was still a bit cross with Missy Hissy for laughing at him earlier, so he thought he'd play a trick on her. Teddy knocked on Missy Hissy's pipes. What a shock she had when she saw the giant beetle. Teddy took off his mask and called to Missy Hissy. She asked Teddy if he'd seen it. A giant beetle, a great big beetle with huge feelers and great big buggy eyes. Like this? Asked Teddy. Teddy told her that it was nothing to be afraid of. Just a beetle mask, he said, that Andy Pandy had helped him to make. Teddy hadn't noticed that Andy Pandy had crept up on him. Then Andy Pandy and Teddy played Beatles until it was time for tea.
Can be Teddy too. Play
One morning, Teddy's house was full of very strange sounds. Andy Pandy wanted to know what was making them. Teddy was making the strange sounds. There was no honey in his cupboard, and he'd had no breakfast. His tummy was so empty, it was rumbling. But Andy had a jar of honey at home, so he'd make honey sandwiches for Teddy's breakfast. Teddy could hardly wait for Andy to open his special cupboard. But when Andy opened the cupboard, they both had a great surprise. They'd never met such a noisy ball. Andy thought it was very funny to see the ball chase Teddy round the room, but Teddy didn't think it was at all funny. The ball wanted Andy to play with it, so he did. Andy and Teddy didn't notice that the ball had rolled out of the house. Where could the noisy ball have gone? Andy and Teddy ran out to the garden. Andy and Teddy were soon having a great game with the noisy ball. Tiffo thought the game sounded fun, and he tried to join in. Tiffo tried to kick the ball like Andy and Teddy, but he got far too many legs. The noisy ball had made a terrible mess in Looby Lou's house. Looby was very cross with it. Andy promised Looby that he and Teddy would help her tidy up. Looby was pleased, but Teddy wasn't very good at tidying up. It took a long time to put everything right in Looby Lou's house, but as soon as they'd finished, Andy and Teddy couldn't wait to play with the noisy ball again. Andy and Teddy thought the ball was trying to hide, and they wanted to play a trick on it. Andy hadn't kicked the noisy ball, he'd kicked Orby, who'd just been having a rest in the fresh air. Andy was very sorry and tried to make him feel better. The noisy ball was waiting for them. Andy told Orby all about their new friend, and Orby wanted to join in their games. He tried to make friends, but the noisy ball didn't seem pleased to meet another ball. At first, Andy and Teddy thought the noisy ball was playing, but then it bumped Orby very hard and started to chase him all around the playground. Bilbo and Missy Hissy had heard all the noise. They soon saw that the noisy ball wasn't very friendly after all. Teddy thought it was time the ball went away. The naughty ball went up, up, and away. Orby was pleased that the noisy ball had gone. Andy Pandy said that there was really only one ball they wanted as a friend, and that was Orby. Now there was another strange noise. It was Teddy's tummy again. In all the excitement, he'd forgotten how hungry he was. But it wasn't long before Andy had made lots of honey sandwiches. They soon made everyone very happy.
Fun. Here comes Andy Pandy. In Andy Pandy.
Looby Lou was showing Teddy how to make daisy chains. Teddy was collecting lots of daisies for Looby Lou. She made a little hole in the stem and threaded the next one through. Teddy asked if he could have a go. Looby Lou said that Teddy must be very careful. Daisy chains were easily broken. Teddy wasn't quite as good as Looby Lou at making daisy chains. His paws were too big to make the hole in the stem. Looby Lou told Teddy to be careful. Tiffo thought Teddy was playing a game. He wanted to join in. Looby Lou and Teddy were very surprised. For a moment, they just watched in amazement as Tiffo pulled the daisy chain to pieces. Then Looby Lou told Tiffo to stop. So he did. But the daisy chain wasn't a daisy chain anymore. It was a bit of a mess. Looby Lou said it was all Teddy's fault. Tiffo said he was very sorry. He was only playing. Andy Pandy was busy in his garden when Teddy passed by. He waved to his little friend, but Teddy didn't wave back. He was feeling too sorry for himself. Teddy told him about the daisy chain and how Looby Lou wasn't very pleased with him. Andy Pandy told Teddy not to worry. He would show Teddy how to make something just as good as a daisy chain and a bit more colourful too. And when they made it, said Andy, Teddy could take it to Looby Lou. Perhaps she'd forgive him then. Teddy watched as Andy Pandy went to his special cupboard. Andy Pandy found some glue, a paintbrush, a pair of scissors, a pair of thin knitting needles, and some magazines. Andy Pandy told Teddy to find some colourful pictures in the magazines and tear them out. Steady, Teddy. Next, Andy Pandy began to cut the pictures up. He cut a long, thin oblong. Then he cut a triangle out of the oblong. Teddy didn't see how these shapes were going to make anything like a daisy chain. Andy Pandy asked Teddy to paint the shapes with glue. Teddy enjoyed that. Next, Andy Pandy asked Teddy to roll the shapes round the knitting needle. Soon Teddy had made a little round paper bead. Andy Pandy told Teddy to put it to one side and leave it to dry. Teddy rolled the next piece of paper round the needle. Soon they had made quite a lot of paper beads. Andy Pandy said they'd have to leave them to dry now, so they went off to play. As Andy and Teddy played football, Looby Lou passed by. Andy Pandy asked her if she'd like to play too, but Looby Lou was still cross with Teddy. When Andy Pandy and Teddy got back, the beads were dry. The next thing they had to do was to thread them. Andy found some red string and told Teddy he could put the beads on it. Steady, Teddy. Teddy started to thread the beads again. This time he was a lot more careful. Soon, Teddy had made a lovely, colourful paper bead necklace. They thought that Looby Lou would be very pleased indeed with the necklace. They soon arrived at Looby Lou's house. Looby Lou was very pleased to see Andy Pandy. But she wasn't so pleased to see Teddy. She still hadn't forgiven him for what he'd done to her daisy chain. Teddy said he was really, really sorry, but he hoped that the bead necklace he and Andy Pandy had made would help make it up to her. Looby Lou loved the necklace, and so Teddy was quite forgiven. Handy Pandy wanted to draw a picture of his favourite chair. He looked in his special cupboard to see what colour of ink he could find. Andy had never seen this strange bottle before. The strange bottle was full of bright blue ink, just the right colour for Andy's drawing. Bilbo had come to ask Andy for help. He wanted to invite all of his friends for a picnic to celebrate the day he'd first set sail on his travels. But he didn't have any ink to write the invitations. Andy said he had lots of ink and would be happy to give some to Bilbo. Next door, Teddy had so many jars of honey, he was going to keep them all in a box. He wanted to draw a picture of a bee on his box to remind him that inside there was honey. Teddy had a pen, but he had no ink. What should he do now? Bilbo had written out his invitations with Andy's ink. Now it was time to deliver them to his friends. First to Orby, then to Missy Hissy. Tiffo was very excited and wanted to help. He ran to Looby-Loo's house and left the invitation on the floor. Andy was so pleased with his drawing that he wanted to show it to Looby-Loo right away. Teddy had come to borrow some ink. Andy said he could borrow as much as he liked. Looby-Loo couldn't wait to see Andy's drawing. But there was nothing on Andy's paper. What could have happened to his drawing? Bilbo gave Tiffo an invitation to give to Teddy. Teddy was so pleased with his drawing, he wanted to show it to Andy Pandy right away. He had never seen this card before, and he wondered why there was nothing on it. When Andy Pandy got home, he found another card with nothing on it. Teddy wanted Andy to come with him right away. Bilbo was waiting for his friends. Been waiting all afternoon, but nobody had come to his picnic. Teddy wanted to surprise Andy with his drawing. There was no drawing. Bilbo wanted to know why Looby-Loo hadn't come to his picnic. And she told him she hadn't found an invitation, just a card with nothing on it. This was the very card on which Bilbo had written her invitation. But all of Bilbo's writing had vanished. Just Andy Pandy's drawing had vanished. Bilbo guessed what had happened. Bilbo said that the ink in Andy's strange bottle must be invisible ink. That's why Andy's drawing and the invitations Bilbo had written with the invisible ink had faded away. Andy wanted to know if the writing would ever come back. Bilbo thought it might come back if they heated it. Yes, the writing on Bilbo's invitation was coming back. So everyone was invited to the picnic after all. And now the sun had warmed his ink. They could all see Andy Pandy's drawing. And they could see Teddy's bee. And very good it was, too. One sunny morning, Tiffo and Teddy had been playing chase the stick. But Teddy had thrown it rather too hard, and it was stuck in the branches of the tree. It was just too high for them to reach. Bilbo was going for a morning voyage in his boat. He suggested that they find another stick. Tiffo said that wasn't a good idea. The stick in the tree was his very favourite stick, and he wanted it back. Playing with another stick just would not be the same. Missy Hissy arrived. She wondered what all the fuss was about. When Teddy told her that Tiffo's favourite stick was stuck, she said she'd try to unstick it. But Missy Hissy couldn't climb the tree. The bark on the tree trunk was a little bit scratchy and very tickly. Teddy said that it looked as if their game of chase the stick would have to wait until the wind blew the stick out of the tree. When Missy Hissy stopped giggling, she wondered where everyone had gone. Andy Pandy was repainting Looby Loo's house when a rather glum Teddy came by. Andy Pandy thought Teddy looked a bit down in the dumps, which he was. Teddy told Andy Pandy all about losing Tiffo's favourite stick in the tree and about how no one could reach it. Andy Pandy said that as he just about finished painting Looby Loo's house, he'd see what he could do to help. And, said Andy Pandy, the paint pots were just the thing they needed. Teddy wondered how paint pots were going to help to get the stick back. Andy Pandy was going to need more things to help Teddy, so he looked in his special cupboard. When Andy Pandy came out again, he brought with him some paint and paintbrushes, some gold and silver stickers, some rope and a bradawl. The bradawl looked a bit like a tiny screwdriver. Andy Pandy told Teddy it wasn't a screwdriver, it was a tool for making holes in the paint pots. Andy Pandy said he'd better make the holes. The bradawl might slip and Teddy could hurt himself. So Teddy watched as Andy Pandy made two holes in each paint pot high up on the sides. Now, said Andy Pandy, it was time to decorate the paint pots. This is Teddy, Teddy. Teddy got almost as much paint on himself as he did on the paint pots. But he didn't mind. He was enjoying himself. Soon, both the paint pots were looking very bright and cheerful. Then, when they were dry, Andy Pandy and Teddy made them look even more cheerful by sticking the gold and silver stickers on them. The stickers were sticky, all right. But at last, they stuck the stickers where they were supposed to stick. Teddy thought the paint pots looked very smart indeed, but then he remembered why they were making them. How were they going to help get Tiffo's stick out of the tree? Andy Pandy told Teddy that he was going to have to wait and see. Andy Pandy put the ends of the rope through the holes in the paint pot, then tied the ends together. Then he put the lid on. Teddy had been watching and he did the same with the other pot. Andy Pandy said they were ready. Ready for what? Wondered Teddy. Andy showed him. They had made some stilts. Teddy could hardly wait for his turn. Oh, oh, Teddy, Teddy. Now to get Tiffo's stick. The stilts made Teddy just tall enough to reach Tiffo's stick. Wouldn't Tiffo be pleased when Teddy took his stick back? Tiffo was playing with another stick when Teddy arrived. He was quite surprised when he nearly bumped into the paint pots. Teddy told Tiffo about how he got his favourite stick back from the tree. Tiffo thanked Teddy but said that he got a new favourite stick. Perhaps Teddy would like to play with them again tomorrow. All that bother for nothing, thought Teddy. But Andy Pandy said it had not been for nothing. Teddy had a brand new pair of stilts. Handy Pandy was busy laying out knives and forks. Looby Lou was going to bring one of her tasty pies for supper. Andy needed some plates. Inside the cupboard, he'd seen another Andy Pandy. The other Andy Pandy was copying everything Andy did. Andy wondered how the other Andy had got inside his cupboard. So he went outside to find the place where the other Andy Pandy had climbed through the wall into the back of the cupboard. Looby Lou had finished baking her tasty pie and was taking it to Andy's house. At first, Looby thought she'd seen another Looby Lou in Andy's cupboard, but when she looked again, she knew she was seeing herself in a mirror. She could see herself dance. Andy hadn't found how the other Andy Pandy had got into his cupboard. But now he saw a Looby Lou in the cupboard. Looby told Andy that there weren't any Andys or Loobies in the cupboard. There was a mirror. It was the biggest mirror Andy had ever seen. He thought that their friends might like to look at themselves in it. So Andy and Looby took the mirror outside. Before they told their friends about the mirror, Andy thought they should try a piece of Looby's tasty pie. Teddy was out for an evening stroll. He thought he'd seen another bear. Teddy was worried that the other bear might take all his honey while he wasn't looking, so he tried to frighten it away. But the other bear frightened Teddy away. Missy Hissy was out for an early evening slither. She wanted to know why Teddy was hiding. When he told her about the other bear, she went to fetch help. Andy Pandy was surprised to hear about the other bear, but Looby thought Teddy must have seen himself in Andy's mirror. So off they went to help him. Teddy didn't believe he'd seen himself in a mirror and wouldn't come out from behind a tree. Andy said they should ask Bilbo what to do. He'd be sure to know. And of course he did. He let Andy and Looby borrow the small mirror he'd always taken on his travels and told them to show Teddy how anyone can see themselves in a mirror. Teddy thought he'd seen yet another bear. Now he thought there were three bears, until Looby showed him how mirrors work. At last, Teddy understood. There weren't any other bears after all. And Teddy wanted to look at himself in the big mirror. Teddy thought that he was the finest looking bear he'd ever seen. And when Andy Pandy said he could keep the mirror in his own house, Teddy was thrilled. Andy and Looby had asked Teddy to share the tasty pie with them. But he was far too busy admiring himself. One morning, Andy Pandy took his football to Tiffo's house. They were having a great game. Then Andy Pandy gave the ball a really hard kick. It went like a rocket and Tiffo followed it. Looby Lou was hard at work in her garden when it arrived. She hadn't been expecting it at all. And she certainly hadn't been expecting a galumphing Tiffo. Looby Lou didn't like people playing games in her flower bed. Tiffo said he was sorry. Andy Pandy said it was his fault. Anyway, it was just lucky that her flower bed had no flowers in it. Ah, but it soon would have. Looby Lou had been planting seeds that would grow into flowers, just so long as the birds didn't eat the seeds first. Andy Pandy told Tiffo that there were no birds around just now, and he knew just the very way to make sure that the birds wouldn't come and eat Looby Lou's seeds when she wasn't looking. Andy Pandy said he'd be back later with a special bird scarer. When he got home, Andy Pandy went to his special cupboard. There he found two lengths of wood, some strong glue, a piece of cord, an old pair of gloves, and a rather moth-eaten jacket. Then he got to work. He put glue on one of the pieces of wood. Then, when he'd stuck the other piece to it, he made sure that the join was good and strong by tying the pieces together. Then he went back to Looby Lou's house to finish the job. When Andy Pandy got there, he asked Looby Lou if she had an old pillowcase and something to stuff it with. Looby Lou said she had. She'd been making cushions for her sofa a few days ago and still had quite a lot of the stuffing left. Soon Andy Pandy had stuffed the pillowcase. Andy Pandy still had a bit of cord left over and he'd tied the pillowcase onto the wooden cross. It looked like a head. He put the jacket and the gloves on too. Now it was beginning to look like, well, a scarecrow, which is what they had made. Looby Lou said the scarecrow ought to have eyes and a mouth. The buttons would make lovely eyes and the felt would give their scarecrow a great big smile. Now their scarecrow was finished. Well, almost finished. Looby Lou said that it needed a final touch, an old hat. That ought to keep the birds away from Looby Lou's seeds.
Oh.
Then Looby Lou remembered she'd asked Teddy and Andy Pandy for tea. She'd been so busy making the scarecrow she'd quite forgotten. While Looby Lou was making tea for them all, Andy Pandy said he'd show the scarecrow where it lived. The sun was beginning to set as Andy Pandy put the scarecrow in the flower bed. Teddy was hungry, and he was so looking forward to his tea that he didn't see Andy Pandy or the scarecrow. Looby Lou had made them a delicious tea. Teddy particularly liked the sausages on sticks. He'd eaten 26. Looby Lou thought 26 was quite enough sausages for one day, so he had some cake instead. When they'd finished eating, Teddy noticed it was getting dark. It was getting late, nearly bedtime. Too late to help with the washing up? Asked Andy Pandy. But Teddy pretended he hadn't heard. When Teddy saw the scarecrow, he didn't know who it was, but he didn't like the look of it at all. In fact, the longer he looked at it, the scareder he got. So scared that he just had to run for help. Help! Shouted Teddy. He told them there was someone lurking in Looby Lou's flower bed. Andy Pandy and Looby Lou knew what had scared Teddy. Andy Pandy told Teddy not to worry. He'd been scared by the scarecrow. If the scarecrow could scare Teddy, said Looby Lou, then it would certainly keep the birds off her seeds. And as he was back in her house, perhaps now Teddy could help with the washing up.
So much fun. Here comes Andy Pandy in Andy Pandy land.
Looby Lou had brought Andy Pandy a present, some young plants she'd grown from a packet of seeds. Andy wanted to put them in his front garden right away, so he fetched his best trowel and hurried outside to dig holes for the plants to live in. Andy knew just where he wanted the plants to grow, and he started digging the first hole. Teddy had got a present too. On his doorstep, he'd found a parcel which had been sent by his uncle, who played music in a teddy bear band. Teddy had never seen a thing like this before. It was long and thin, and had lots of holes in it. But nothing came out of the holes. There was another hole at one end, but Teddy couldn't see anything inside. So he thought he'd try blowing into the long, thin thing. Now Teddy knew what his present was. It was a whistle, just like the one his uncle played in the teddy bear band. Just as he was going to play a tune, Tiffo came to ask if they could play a game together. Teddy was pleased with his tune, but Tiffo didn't like it at all. He thought it was an awful noise. Teddy couldn't wait to play his whistle for his friends, but first he had to tidy up. Tiffo wanted to make sure the awful noise had really stopped. He'd never seen a whistle before and thought that this must be a long, thin bone Teddy had left out for him. He decided to bury it in a secret place until he was hungry. Andy Pandy had finished the holes for his new plants, and he went indoors to fetch them. Tiffo was delighted to find that someone had already dug some holes. This was the very place to bury his new bone. Then he could go and tell his friends about the long, thin bone he'd buried in a secret place. Andy was ready to put his plants into their new homes. Tiffo had found Looby Lou, and he told her all about the long, thin bone he'd just buried. He was very pleased. But Teddy was very worried. His brand new whistle had vanished. Where could it have gone? It must have rolled away, but where to? Teddy looked every way he could think of, but the whistle wasn't anywhere in his garden. Perhaps it had rolled all the way onto the green. Orby and Missy Hissy were enjoying themselves in the sunshine, but Teddy was still looking for his missing whistle. He thought the long, thin whistle might be hidden under Missy Hissy. After all, she was long and thin. Teddy made her slither aside. And when there was nothing to be found under Missy Hissy, Teddy made Orby roll aside. But Teddy still couldn't find his whistle. Andy was sure he'd put all his new plants into their holes, but all the holes were full and one plant was still left on the tray. Andy thought he must have counted them wrongly. Still, he was now very good at putting his plants in their new homes, and he soon dug another hole. Luby had come to see how the new plants looked. She thought they'd grow beautifully, but she noticed that there was a gap in the row of plants. Teddy had searched all over the green, and now he was looking for his whistle in Andy's garden. When he told them about his missing present, Luby guessed what had happened. She remembered that Tiffo had told her about the long, thin bone he'd buried in a secret place. Perhaps Andy's garden was the secret place. Andy soon found something very strange. It was Teddy's whistle. Teddy wanted to play it right away, but Luby said as the whistle had been buried in the ground, they should clean it first. As soon as his new whistle was cleaned, Teddy started to play it. Andy and Luby could soon tell that Teddy hadn't yet learned how to play his new whistle. Andy suggested that perhaps Teddy could let someone else have a turn at playing it. Teddy knew Luby loved music, so he let her try his whistle first. And Luby played the whistle beautifully.
As he can be, Teddy too.
One morning, Looby Lou had asked Teddy whether he'd like to help her make some shortbread biscuits. He was a bit late. He hoped she hadn't started without him. But she hadn't. She'd put everything they needed on the table. Flour, cocoa powder, caster sugar, butter and milk. Teddy wanted to know what they were going to do first, so Looby Lou showed him. Looby Lou asked him to sift some flour and cocoa powder into the mixing bowl. Steady, Teddy. But Teddy had been sifting so eagerly, some flour had gone up his nose. Looby Lou thought that perhaps they'd better start again. This time, Teddy was much more careful. Then Looby Lou added the sugar. The next thing they needed was butter, softened butter, so that it was easy to rub into the flour, cocoa and sugar. She asked Teddy if he'd like to do this. Steady, Teddy. Soon the mixture looked a bit like breadcrumbs. The last ingredient was a tablespoonful of milk, just enough to bind the mixture together. Looby Lou thought she should do this. She mixed the shortbread mixture with her hands until she'd made a nice round ball. No, not that sort of ball, Teddy. Looby Lou cut the dough into pieces and then flattened them into biscuit shapes. Teddy helped. The biscuits were ready to go into the oven. Teddy had found two wooden spoons. They made a fine noise. So did everything else in Looby Lou's house. But Looby Lou wasn't so keen on Teddy's drumming. She asked Teddy to go and play somewhere else until the biscuits were ready. Teddy wondered what he could use to drum on. Then he thought of just the place. Teddy's drumming was louder than ever. Missy Hissy was very startled. Whatever could be happening? Stop, Teddy! Teddy had been making such a noise that the others soon arrived to find out what was going on. Missy Hissy told them that she'd been having a peaceful snooze when she was wakened by the loudest banging she'd ever heard. Handy Pandy told Teddy that he'd show him something else to do with wooden spoons, something a little bit quieter. When they got back to Handy Pandy's house, Handy Pandy went to his special cupboard and found a box of paints and two brushes, some glue, some string and two squares of colourful cloth. Handy Pandy asked Teddy for one of the wooden spoons. Handy Pandy began to paint a face on the wooden spoon. Two big blue eyes and a big smiley mouth. Teddy did too. Next, Handy Pandy showed Teddy how to put glue around the handle of the wooden spoon, just below the face. Teddy liked gluing. Last of all, they tied the cloth to the gluey bits on the handles. They made two wooden spoon puppets.
Hello, Teddy. Hello, Handy Pandy.
The puppets were very good dancers and singers.
Pum pa pum pa pum 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 pa pum pa pum pum pum.
Handy Pandy said the puppets had done very well indeed. Teddy said that they should go and show Looby Lou. Even though they were her wooden spoons, Looby Lou thought the puppets were just great. Handy Pandy and Teddy said the shortbread biscuits were delicious. And the puppets thought so too.
As he can be, Teddy too.
Handy Pandy, Looby Loo and Teddy were enjoying lunch in the fresh air. But then they heard a strange buzzing sound. It got nearer and nearer until it arrived at the picnic table. It was a wasp. It must have seen the food. But did the wasp want the food, or did it just want to be a nuisance? Teddy thought the wasp wanted to chase him, so he tried to chase the wasp away. The wasp was causing so much trouble and noise that Tiffo came to see what was going on. Looby pointed out the wasp, and Tiffo promised that he'd chase it away. At last, the wasp was flying off. Missy Hissy had heard the noise on the green and wanted to see what it was all about. But now the wasp was flying towards Missy Hissy. She didn't like wasps at all. Tiffo was lying in wait for the wasp. But the wasp stung Tiffo. Poor Tiffo's front paw was hurting. He could hardly walk. Now the wasp had gone. Andy, Teddy and Looby were enjoying their lunch again. They all felt very sorry that Tiffo's foot hurt, and Andy and Teddy tried to help him walk. But that didn't work. What could they do? Tiffo had to go for walks. After all, that's what dogs like to do. They like to go for walks. Bilbo had an idea. He said they should make a car for Tiffo and push him around in it. He had some wheels they could use. And he had some wood they could fix the wheels onto. And Looby had a box that Tiffo could sit in. So off they went to make his car. Looby Loo had some special medicine to put on Tiffo's wasp sting. That would soon make it feel better. Andy was very pleased. He was sure the car would work well. So Teddy went to fetch the last wheel from Bilbo. When Looby Loo had put her special medicine onto Tiffo's sting, she showed him the box that would be part of his car. Then she went to get some scissors to cut down one side of the box so that Tiffo would be able to climb inside. Teddy was finding it hard to carry a wheel all on his own, so he thought he'd roll it to Andy's house instead. But the wheel wouldn't go where Teddy wanted it to go. Every time Teddy tried to catch the wheel, it rolled away. Andy thought Teddy had been very clever to roll the wheel from Bilbo's house. Teddy thought he'd been clever too. Looby told them that the box was ready to be put on top of the wheels. So they went to fetch the box. Andy and Teddy soon finished making his car. Bilbo thought they'd done a fine job, and so did everyone. Tiffo couldn't wait to have his first ride. And his car really did work very well. He liked it even better than going for a walk. Tiffo liked riding in his car so much that he wouldn't let Andy and Teddy stop. It was nearly supper time, and still Tiffo wanted to ride in his car. But Andy and Teddy couldn't push or pull any more. This made Tiffo cross. But he made Teddy even crosser. Tiffo was running home. The wasp sting wasn't hurting anymore. Andy and Teddy had spent all afternoon pushing Tiffo around, even though Looby's medicine had made his paw better long before. Still, Looby knew how hard they'd worked and brought them a splendid supper. And this time there were no wasps to get in their way.
Andy Pandy.
One morning, Teddy, Tiffo and Orby were playing in the garden. The game took Teddy, Tiffo and Orby as far as Bilbo's boathouse. Then Tiffo noticed something odd. The boathouse seemed to have smoke coming out of it. Maybe Bilbo was in trouble. They'd better see what was going on. But it wasn't smoke. It was dust. It got up their noses and made them sneeze quite a lot. Bilbo wondered what all the noise was, and Teddy wondered why there was so much dust coming out of Bilbo's boathouse. Bilbo told them how an aunt of his had given him an old and very dusty piano. He'd been cleaning it up. That's what had made all the dust. Now he was going to play the piano. Teddy, Tiffo and Orby were very excited. As Bilbo played, Teddy, Tiffo and Orby danced. Then the piano made a funny noise. Not a piano sort of noise at all. Bilbo thought it sounded strange too. Teddy wondered whether there might be something inside the piano. Teddy was right. There had been something in the piano. It was a cardboard box. But what was in it? Maybe it was treasure. Bilbo opened the box and took out a metal bolt. The box was full of rather boring bolts. A piano was a funny place to leave a box of bolts, but that was just like his auntie, said Bilbo. She was sometimes a bit forgetful. He asked Teddy to get rid of the bolts for him. He didn't need them, and he wanted to play his piano again. Teddy took the bolts to Andy Pandy's house. Andy Pandy was always pleased to see Teddy. He asked him what he'd got in the box. So Teddy showed him what was inside. He asked if Andy Pandy wanted the metal bolts. Andy Pandy said he didn't need any bolts at the moment, but he had an idea as to how he and Teddy could use them. Andy Pandy went to his special cupboard. In the cupboard, he found some string, a pair of scissors, his best paint box, and a strong cardboard tube. First of all, Andy Pandy took the scissors and cut some lengths of string. Then he asked Teddy to tie the string to the bolts. Andy Pandy did too. Poor Teddy found he'd tied the first bolts to his paw. Steady, Teddy. Andy Pandy helped Teddy to get the string off his paw. When they'd tied the string to all the bolts, Andy Pandy asked Teddy to paint the cardboard tube. Teddy liked painting. It looked very colourful indeed. When the paint on the tube was dry, Andy Pandy and Teddy tied the bolts to it. Teddy wondered exactly what it was they were making. Wait and see, Teddy. There was one piece of string left. Andy Pandy tied it to the middle of the cardboard tube. Then Andy Pandy asked Teddy to blow at the bolts. So he did. Come on, Teddy, you can blow harder than that. Teddy blew harder. This time, the bolts moved and banged against one another. It made a lovely sound. Teddy was thrilled they'd made some wind chimes. Andy Pandy said they should hang them from the tree in the garden. Then everyone could hear them when the wind blew. The others came to see what was making such a nice noise. All except Bilbo. He was still playing his piano, and he was getting better at it, too. His piano and the wind chimes filled the garden with music. Looby Lou liked the music so much, she started to dance, and they all joined in.
Can be Teddy too, playing in the garden.
One sunny afternoon, Andy Pandy was telling Teddy it was a perfect day for a picnic when... Looby Lou came to show them a postcard. It had come from her cousin, who was on holiday at the seaside. Looby's cousin was having a wonderful time on the beach, and Andy thought a beach looked the perfect place for a picnic. Bilbo was busy tidying his house, and he'd put outside some of his oldest treasures. Orby had never seen anything like these treasures before, and he asked Bilbo what they were. Bilbo told him that this was an old sea chest that he'd brought home from his travels. Orby wanted to know what was inside the old sea chest, but Bilbo couldn't remember, and he couldn't open the heavy lid to look inside. Orby promised to bring some friends to help Bilbo to open his old sea chest. Luby's cousin had told her of the fun she'd had on the beach, with buckets and spades and hampers and picnics. Andy had a bucket and spade in his special cupboard. At home, Luby had a hamper and everything they'd need for a picnic. The only thing they didn't have was a beach. But they forgot all about that when Orby asked them to help Bilbo open his old sea chest. Andy had brought his spade, as he thought it might help lift the lid. Everyone wanted to see what was inside the chest. It was full of golden sand. Bilbo had brought the sand home to remind him of the many happy times he'd spent on golden beaches. Andy wondered if they could use the sand to make their own beach, and Bilbo said that they could lay out his old tarpaulin and spread the sand on that. Once Bilbo's tarpaulin had been laid out, the green soon started to look like a golden beach. Looby brought everything she could think of to make their beach look like the beach on her cousin's postcard. As soon as it was ready, Andy and his friends tried out their brand new beach. Andy wondered what they should do next. Luby's cousin had told her how she'd built sandcastles with her bucket and spade. So that's what they did next. Everyone was delighted with their sandcastle, and Luby had even brought some flags to go on top. Now it was time for their picnic. It was a fine picnic, and everyone agreed it was so much finer for being on their very own beach. Missy Hissy had seen the beach from the top of her house and wanted to join in. Luby's cousin and her friends had buried their legs in the sand, and Missy Hissy said she'd love to be buried, but just a bit. Tiffo saw Andy and Teddy digging and thought their brand new beach would be just the place to bury his brand new bone. Tiffo sent sand flying over everyone and over their picnic. So it was agreed that there should be no more burying. Luby's cousin had told her how lovely it was to sleep on a beach. And even though it was getting dark, Andy, Luby and Teddy didn't want to leave their beach just yet. So they decided to sleep there. But during the night, it got colder and the wind began to blow. Everyone thought it was time to clear up and go home before the beach blew away. Bilbo's sea chest was filled with golden sand once again, and Andy, Luby and Teddy were tucked up in their own beds. They'd never forget the day they'd spent on their very own beach, but they were glad to be home. Handy Pandy was a little puzzled one afternoon. He hadn't seen Teddy all day. He wondered where he was. He went to ask Looby Lou if she'd seen Teddy, but she hadn't. Tiffo hadn't seen him either, nor had Missy Hissy, Orby, or Bilbo. Perhaps Teddy had been at home all the time. Teddy had been having a very lazy day. He'd been sitting in his chair, eating crisps and drinking fizzy drinks. Andy asked Teddy if he wanted to come out and play. Teddy said he didn't really feel like it, but Andy could have a crisp if he wanted. Andy Pandy didn't think Teddy was getting enough exercise. Teddy thought he was getting plenty. Andy Pandy asked Teddy to come on a little run with him in the morning. He'd show him what real exercise was. So Teddy agreed. The next morning, Andy Pandy was up bright and early. When Andy Pandy got to Teddy's house, Teddy looked very sleepy indeed. Andy Pandy told him it was time for their exercise. Teddy hadn't had his breakfast yet, but Andy Pandy told him they could have breakfast later, after the exercise, and if Teddy put a bit of effort into it, Andy Pandy would treat him to a really big breakfast. Teddy did a few exercises, but Andy said he hadn't done enough yet to earn his breakfast. They were going to go for a run. Tiffo thought his visitors had come to play, but Andy Pandy explained that they were on a run. At last they reached the end of their run. Teddy was quite tired. He was very hungry too. Andy said that while he cooked them a really tasty breakfast, Teddy could help himself to some cereal. Teddy, Teddy! Teddy said he was sorry and went to get a brush and dustpan to sweep up the mess. It seemed a pity to waste so much cereal. But it didn't need to go to waste. Teddy said it wasn't a good idea to eat food that had fallen on the floor. But they weren't going to eat it. Andy Pandy went to his special cupboard and found a piece of cardboard, a sheet of red paper, some glue and a paintbrush. Andy Pandy asked Teddy to glue the paper to the cardboard. Teddy liked gluing. While they were waiting for the glue to dry, they could have their breakfast, said Andy Pandy. Teddy, Teddy. After they'd finished their breakfast, Teddy went to see if the glue had dried. It had. Now for the next bit. Andy Pandy asked Teddy to paint a picture on the paper with glue. So he did. But he couldn't see what he'd painted. It was almost as if there was nothing on the paper at all. Andy told Teddy that this was where the cereal came in. He asked him to sprinkle it over the paper. Then he asked him to shake it gently off again. Some of the cereal stuck to the glue, and at last Teddy could see what he had painted. And very good it was, too.
So much fun.
Looby Lou was so pleased with the biscuits she'd just baked, she invited Andy Pandy to taste them. Andy was going to ask Looby for another biscuit when they heard a bird singing outside. It was singing so beautifully, they wanted to see the bird. But when they looked outside, it had flown away. Looby had an idea. She thought that if they put some of her biscuits outside, the bird might fly down to eat them, and they'd be able to see it. They went home to wait for the bird to find the biscuits. But Teddy had come out for a walk, and he found the biscuits. He was sure nobody would mind if he tried one, and he was sure nobody would mind if he tried the other one. Andy and Looby waited all morning and all afternoon, but the bird who'd sung so beautifully didn't come back. Teddy wondered where Andy and Looby had been all day. Now he'd found them. He told them all about the tasty biscuits he'd found on the picnic table. At last, Andy and Looby knew why the bird hadn't flown down to eat the biscuits. Teddy wanted to know why Andy and Looby were looking so sad, so Andy told him about the bird and the biscuits they'd left out for it. Teddy was sorry he'd eaten the biscuits, but they had been very tasty. Andy told Bilbo all about the bird and its beautiful song, and Bilbo said that if they got up as early in the morning as he did, they'd hear the beautiful singing of the dawn chorus when all the birds wake up and sing to each other. They all agreed they'd get up at dawn the very next day. The next morning, Looby Lou was still asleep when the sun came up, and Andy Pandy was still asleep, and Teddy was still asleep as well. Bilbo had been waiting for a very long time. But when Andy, Looby and Teddy finally arrived, Bilbo had to tell them that they'd slept so late that they'd missed the dawn chorus. He said that if they wanted to hear the dawn chorus next day, they should try an old trick he'd learned at sea. Before they went to bed, they must each tie one end of a very long string to one of their feet and hang the other end over the playground gate. Then at dawn, Bilbo would tug the strings to wake them all. Tiffo often liked to go for a stroll as soon as it was dark. And when he saw the strings, he thought they must be a toy, so he started to play with them. Now Andy, Looby and Teddy were all awake. Tiffo had finished his game and gone home, so there was no one there to tell them it was still early in the night, and it would be many, many hours until dawn. They wondered where Bilbo was and settled down to wait for him. But they were all very tired, and it wasn't long before they were fast asleep. Many, many hours later, Bilbo came out to wake Andy, Looby and Teddy. He was surprised to see they were up already, and he was even more surprised to see they were all fast asleep. No matter how hard he tried, Bilbo just could not wake them to hear the bird's dawn chorus. So he blew his ship's whistle. They all woke up. The whistle was very loud. But none of them could hear the dawn chorus. The ship's whistle had driven all the birds away. Everyone was very sorry to have missed the dawn chorus once again, but Looby invited them home for an early breakfast. They were tucking into Looby's breakfast when they heard a beautiful sound. It was the song of the bird Andy and Looby had heard the other day. This time, Andy could see the bird. It was only a small brown bird, but that didn't matter because it sang such a beautiful song.
As he can be, Teddy too, playing.
parcel had arrived one morning. It was for Teddy, and Andy Pandy was taking it to him. Missy Hissy wondered what was inside. Andy Pandy told her that they'd have to wait for Teddy to open it. Oops! Teddy hadn't seen the box. But when he did, his fall was soon forgotten. He wondered what it was. Andy Pandy said he didn't know either, and they wouldn't find out until Teddy opened it. Teddy was very excited. A parcel for him? Steady, Teddy. Inside the box was a pair of skates. They were a present from Teddy's rich uncle in America. Teddy was thrilled. He couldn't wait to get them on. Missy Hissy asked if she could have the string. It would come in very useful in her pipes. Missy Hissy was very pleased with her string. Teddy was ready to try out the skates, but they weren't easy to stand on. They were even harder to roll on. But Teddy soon got the idea. Well done, Teddy. Teddy thought he was ready to skate a bit further now. One, two, three, go! Looby Lou was in her garden weeding the flower beds. Some of them didn't want to be pulled up at all. She was so busy, she didn't hear Teddy coming. Look out, Teddy! When Andy Pandy got to Looby Lou's house, she told him that a strange something had just whizzed past her. That was Teddy, Andy Pandy told her. Teddy explained how his skates had run away with him and how there had nearly been a nasty accident. Looby Lou asked if she could have a go on Teddy's skates. Teddy said he wanted to practice a bit more first. Looby Lou was a bit disappointed. She'd have liked a go at skating. Never mind, said Andy Pandy. He got something that was almost as good as a pair of skates. Andy found a scooter and a trike. When Looby Lou saw what Andy Pandy had found, she was thrilled. Andy Pandy asked her if she'd like to have a go on the scooter. She couldn't wait. Then Teddy whizzed up and joined them. There was nearly another accident. When Teddy saw the scooter and the trike, he had an idea. Why didn't they have a race round the garden? Andy Pandy and Looby said that sounded like fun. Soon they were ready. Everyone had come to watch the race, and Bilbo was going to start them off. Ready, steady, go! They raced as fast as they could, but Teddy was the fastest. They raced on and on. When they got to Orby's house, Teddy was quite a long way in the lead, but he wasn't looking where he was going. Steady, Teddy. Teddy was soon back in the race. By the time Teddy got to Missy Hissy's pipes, he was well in the lead. The finishing line wasn't far away. He was bound to win, he thought. But Teddy hadn't noticed the string that Missy Hissy had asked for earlier. Teddy was standing on it, and it was tangled round the wheels of his skate. Bye-bye, Teddy. The finishing line was in sight, and everyone was cheering. Andy Pandy made sure that they tied for first place. Teddy came last. He wasn't very pleased. Until Looby Lou asked everyone to come to tea. That cheered him up.
As he can be, Teddy too, playing in the garden.
Pandy had found something strange in his special cupboard. It was a huge onion. But Andy didn't know that. He'd never seen anything like it before and wondered what it could be. It smelled rather odd, but Andy found that he could pull off the brown skin and look inside. Was it something he could eat? The more Andy cut into the strange object, the more he was sniffing. And now he was crying, even though he was perfectly happy. Teddy had come to visit Andy, and he was very sad to see him crying. He asked what was wrong. But Andy was crying so much he couldn't answer. Teddy went to fetch help. Looby Lou was busy making soup when Teddy came to call. He told her Andy Pandy was crying, and Looby told Teddy to cheer Andy up by making him laugh. She lent him her feather duster so that he could tickle Andy. Andy was still crying, though he didn't know why, and he was still trying to find out what was inside the huge onion. Teddy tickled Andy as hard as he could, but Andy didn't seem to notice. However much Teddy tickled Andy, he kept on sniffing and crying. While Teddy went off to think of another way to make him laugh, Andy went to ask Looby Lou if she knew what the strange object was that he'd found in his cupboard. Looby had never seen such a thing before. Andy asked her to try to find what was inside. Now Looby Lou was crying. Andy wanted to cheer her up, but as soon as he got near the onion, he started crying again. When Teddy came to see if Andy was visiting Looby, he saw them both crying. So he'd have to make them both laugh. But nothing would stop Andy and Looby crying. While Teddy went away to think of another trick that might cheer them up, Andy and Looby decided to take the onion out to the green and ask their friends if they knew what it was and why they couldn't stop crying. Tiffo was having a walk when he heard the sound of sniffing. When he saw Andy and Looby sniffing and crying, he ran off to tell their friends. Missy Hissy had already heard the sniffing and crying, and so had Orby. They all wanted to cheer Andy and Looby up, but how? Teddy asked them to help him, and everyone set off to try and make Andy and Looby laugh. Teddy was sure his new trick would make Andy and Looby laugh. He watched Teddy sit down in a bucket of water, but still they didn't laugh. Tiffo thought his tricks would cheer up Andy and Looby, but they didn't. Now it was Orby's turn. Surely that would make Andy and Looby laugh, but it didn't. Now everyone wanted to know about the strange onion. When Andy said it might be something to eat, Teddy asked to try it for himself. Now everyone was crying. Bilbo had heard all this sniffing and crying and asked what was wrong, but nobody could tell him. Bilbo had seen the onion. Now he knew why everyone was in tears. He told them that it was the smell that came from the onion when they cut into it that was making them cry. As soon as they finished cutting the onion and started cooking it, everyone would stop crying. Looby said she'd take the onion home right away and put it into her pot and make onion soup. Bilbo was right. As soon as Looby put the slices of onion into her soup, there were no more tears. Andy Pandy thought Looby's soup was delicious, and Teddy thought he'd like a little more pepper. But he poured so much pepper, it made him sneeze. At last, Andy and Looby were laughing. And so was Teddy.
So much fun. Here comes Andy Pandy. In Andy Pandy Land.
Pandy, Pandy and Teddy were playing in the garden one day. They were having a race, but it was hard to tell who was in the lead. It was a hot day and racing was thirsty work, so they stopped to have a drink. Teddy made quite a lot of noise with his drink. Andy started to race again before Teddy was ready. Orby had heard Andy, Pandy and Teddy playing, so he bounced over to see what they were up to. Andy, Pandy asked Orby if he'd like to ride on his trike. Teddy asked if he'd like to ride on his scooter. Orby thanked them but said he wasn't really the right shape for riding a trike or a scooter. So Andy, Pandy and Teddy started to race again. Looby Lou had found a piece of string and she was playing cat's cradle with it. Orby wondered what Looby Lou was doing, so she showed him. She asked Orby if he'd like to try. Orby said he didn't think he'd be able to play cat's cradle, he hadn't any fingers. Orby said goodbye. Tiffo was scratching his ear when Orby passed by. Tiffo said there was nothing like a good scratch. Orby wished he could have a good scratch, but he didn't have legs like Tiffo. Missy Hissy was playing catch the snake tail. She was racing in and out of her pipes, trying to catch her tail. Orby thought it must be great fun to play a game like that. He couldn't, though. He didn't have a tail. Missy Hissy didn't know she had a visitor. She got quite a shock when she bumped into Orby. She asked if he'd like to join in. But Orby said he wasn't really quite the right shape for catch the snake tail. By now, Andy, Pandy and Teddy had finished their drinks. But they'd been playing all that time and they were as thirsty as ever. So they went back to Andy Pandy's house to fetch some more. As Orby made his way home, he heard some music. It was coming from Bilbo's boathouse. He thought he'd go and see who was making the music. It was Bilbo. He was playing on a little wooden whistle. Bilbo asked Orby if he'd like to play the whistle. Orby would have loved to, but he'd have been able to play only one note on the whistle. He didn't have any fingers to go on the holes. Then Andy, Pandy and Teddy arrived to listen to Bilbo's whistling. Andy, Pandy noticed that Orby was looking rather sad. He asked Orby what was the matter. So Orby told him. He couldn't play on bikes, and he couldn't play cat's cradle, and he couldn't scratch himself like Tiffo, and he couldn't play catch the snake tail, and he couldn't even play the whistle. Poor Orby. Then Andy Pandy had an idea. He asked Teddy to go back with him to his house to help him. And don't forget the plastic bottles. They're going to come in very handy. When they got back to Andy Pandy's house, Andy found some more plastic bottles and his paint box. They began to paint the bottles. Steady, Teddy. When they'd finished painting the plastic bottles, Andy, Pandy and Teddy took them outside. Then they put a few little stones in each of the bottles to make sure they didn't fall over too easily. When there were enough stones in each of the bottles, they screwed the tops back on. Now to find Orby. When they got to Orby's house, Andy, Pandy and Teddy began to stand the bottles up next to one another. Orby wondered what they were doing. So Andy Pandy told him they'd invented a special game for Orby to play. What he had to do was to roll at the bottles and see how many he could knock over. 6, not bad, but next time he'd do better. 10, well done, Orby. At last, Andy Pandy had found a game that Orby could play. And they played and played until it was time for bed.
Andy Pandy. In Andy Pandy.
Andy Pandy had secretly been growing a bush of flowers as a surprise present for Looby Lou. He was going to plant it in Looby's garden when she wasn't looking. Looby Lou had made some fizzy lemonade, and she was bringing a jug of it for Andy to taste. When Andy heard Looby, he quickly hid the bush. Looby hadn't seen the bush and asked Andy to taste her fizzy lemonade. Andy said the lemonade was delicious. Looby was so delighted she went straight home to make some more. Andy was pleased Looby hadn't seen the flower bush. He went to his special cupboard to find a spade to dig a hole for it. Teddy had come to visit Andy, but Andy was making so much noise that he didn't hear him say hello. Teddy noticed the jug on Andy's table and wondered what was inside. Teddy thought Looby's lemonade looked very tasty, and he just had to try it. Teddy tried to hide before Andy caught him drinking his lemonade without asking. Teddy had drunk the fizzy lemonade so quickly he'd given himself hiccups. When Andy heard the hiccups, he soon found Teddy's hiding place. Andy was pleased to see Teddy, as he needed help in taking the bush to Looby's garden and planting it. Teddy still had hiccups, but Andy knew how to help. A sudden shock would soon cure them. So Andy fetched a bag full of ice. Now they could plant the bush in secret without Looby hearing Teddy's hiccups. Oh no! As soon as he started digging, Teddy's hiccups began again. Looby Lou had heard a strange sound from her garden. But by the time she looked outside, Andy and Teddy had gone. Andy thought it would be best to wait until dark and plant the bush after Looby Lou had gone to bed. While he waited for Teddy, Andy drank the rest of Looby's fizzy lemonade. Teddy had finished his supper and was ready to help. It didn't take Teddy long to dig a hole big enough for the bush, and Andy Pandy was ready to plant it. Oh no! Andy had drunk so much fizzy lemonade he'd given himself hiccups. Looby Lou was fast asleep, but Andy didn't want to wake her. Teddy remembered how Andy had stopped his hiccups, and he tried to give Andy a shock. It had worked. Andy and Teddy planted the bush as quickly as they could. They hurried home before anyone hiccuped again. Next morning, Andy asked Bilbo and Missy Hissy to tell Looby Lou about the flower bush which had grown in her garden during the night, as he wanted to hide and see how surprised she was. Andy and Teddy were thrilled that Looby was so pleased with her new flower bush. At last, it was time for Andy to tell Looby that it was he who'd grown the bush and secretly planted it. Looby told Andy how much she loved the bush and what a wonderful surprise it had been. And she thanked him with a glass of her newest fizzy lemonade. But this time everyone sipped the fizzy lemonade very slowly, and no one got hiccups.
Can be Teddy too, playing in the garden every
It was early one morning, and Teddy was on his way to see if Andy Pandy wanted to come out to play. He knocked at the door. Perhaps Andy Pandy was still asleep. Well, thought Teddy, he'd soon wake him up. Steady, Teddy. No wonder Teddy didn't get a reply. Andy Pandy wasn't at home. Teddy asked Andy Pandy where he'd been. Ah, said Andy Pandy, that's for me to know and you to find out. How would Teddy like to go on a treasure hunt? A treasure hunt? Teddy was thrilled. Andy Pandy explained that he'd left clues with people all around the garden. Each clue would take him to a different place, and when Teddy had worked out all the clues, he'd get a special surprise. And now for the clue that would take Teddy to the first place. This person is quite long and thin. Knock on a pipe to see if she's in. This person is quite long and thin. Knock on a pipe to see if she's in. Of course, the first clue was about Missy Hissy, so that's where Teddy had to go. Missy Hissy took Teddy rather by surprise, but when she told him she had the second clue, he was all ears. You know this person well, I think. The ribbons in her hair are pink. You know this person well, I think. The ribbons in her hair are pink. Oh, yes, Looby Lou has pink ribbons in her hair. It must be her. Looby Lou was waiting outside her house for Teddy. Well done, Teddy. This person likes a bone to chew. He's got a tail and four legs too. This person likes a bone to chew. He's got a tail and four legs too. Oh, that's it. The third clue was about Tiffo. Teddy could hardly wait for the next clue. So Tiffo told him, this person's not like you or me. He lives upon a boat, you see. Tiffo knew the answer, but he wasn't going to tell Teddy. He gave him the clue again. This person's not like you or me. He lives upon a boat, you see. A boat? It must be Bilbo. Teddy wondered what the treasure was going to be. Would it be in a big treasure chest? Bilbo was waiting for Teddy with the fifth clue. Watch out, Teddy! But there was no harm done. Teddy was keen to get on with the treasure hunt. This person's dressed in white and blue. He's got a special cupboard, too. This person's dressed in white and blue. He's got a special cupboard too. Oh, white and blue. It must be Andy Pandy. Teddy didn't waste any time racing over to Andy Pandy's house. Teddy wanted to know if he'd got the treasure. Not quite. There were another couple of clues to solve first, said Andy Pandy. And he gave Teddy the sixth clue. This person's wide as he is tall. He bounces like a rubber ball. This person's wide as he is tall. He bounces like a rubber ball. Ah, it must be Orby. Teddy could hardly wait to hear what the next clue was, so Orby told him. This clue's the last. Now here's a thing. Where would you find a little swing? Where would you find a little swing?
Oh, a swing. There was one in the big tree in the garden, wasn't there?
At last he was going to find the treasure. Well done, Teddy. You worked out all the clues. And here was his prize. A special picnic party. And a great big chocolate cake. Just for Teddy. Teddy said he'd like to share it with everyone. After all, they'd helped him find the treasure, hadn't they?
Handy Pandy had found some pieces of wood in his special cupboard. Handy had never seen these wooden pieces before and didn't know what they were for. Perhaps he could build them into a tower. But the tower fell down. So Andy took the wooden pieces to Looby Lou to ask her if she knew what to do with them. Orby had come out for a roll around the gardens, but he wasn't looking where he was going. So Andy had to jump out of his way. Still, Orby wasn't looking where he was going. No one was hurt. So Andy and Orby went on their way. But Andy hadn't noticed that he'd dropped one of his wooden pieces. And when Tiffo came trotting along, he thought someone had left it for him to play with. That morning, Teddy's auntie had given him a wooden stool for his house, but one of the stool's legs was shorter than the others, and Teddy couldn't make it stand straight. Perhaps the stool would stop wobbling if Teddy sat on it. But it didn't. Tiffo was having a great time with the piece of wood he'd found outside Andy Pandy's house. But he threw it a bit too far and lost it. Looby Lou had never seen anything like Andy's pieces of wood and thought that they all had very odd shapes. Looby had seen that two of the pieces fitted together. She thought that the wooden pieces might be part of a puzzle, so she and Andy tried to fit some of the other pieces together. Andy and Looby were making a picture. Teddy was determined to sit on his new stool, but the stool wouldn't let him sit on it. So Teddy went to ask his friends for help. Teddy saw the piece of wood Tiffo had been playing with. It seemed just the right size to fit under the short leg of his wooden stool. And it was just the right size. Andy and Looby had made their picture. The wooden pieces were all part of a jigsaw puzzle. But there was a hole in the picture. One of the pieces must be missing. So Andy and Looby went to look for it. They went back the way Andy Pandy had walked from his house to see if he'd dropped the missing piece on the way. Andy remembered that it was just here that Orby had bumped into him. Perhaps this is where he dropped the missing piece. But there was nothing to be seen. So Andy and Looby went to look inside Andy's house. The missing piece wasn't on the table, and it wasn't in Andy's special cupboard. Teddy had come to tell Andy and Looby about his new wooden stool. So they forgot about their puzzle and went to look at Teddy's new stool instead. Teddy was now very proud of his wooden stool, and his friends liked it too. Looby had seen the piece of wood that was holding up the leg of the stool. She thought it looked like the wooden pieces of Andy's puzzle. And now Andy saw it was part of their picture of a car. Teddy's stool was wobbling again, but Andy said the stool was probably meant to wobble. It must be a rocking stool. Teddy was thrilled. He had always wanted a rocking stool. Andy Pandy and Looby Lou were thrilled as well. At last, they could finish Andy's puzzle. One morning, Teddy was on his way to pay a visit to Andy Pandy. He was very pleased when he saw him, but what was he holding? Oh, steady, Teddy. Andy Pandy told Teddy that it was an avocado plant. Looby Lou had grown it for him from an avocado stone. Andy Pandy said he was going to plant it in his garden and let it grow even bigger. One day it might even be a tree. Teddy thought it would be nice to have a tree in his garden. He asked if Looby Lou might show him how to grow an avocado plant from an avocado stone. There was only one way to find out. He'd have to go and ask her. Hello, Teddy. Teddy asked Looby Lou if she could show him how to grow an avocado plant from an avocado stone. Teddy was in luck. She had an avocado stone. Now she needed a jam jar with some water in it and a couple of pins. Next, they needed to stick the pins in the stone, said Looby Lou. Teddy wanted to do that, but Looby Lou said the pins were very sharp. She didn't want him to get the pins stuck in his paw. Teddy watched as she stuck the pins halfway down the stone, one on either side. Then she sat the stone on the jam jar. Silly Teddy. These things take time. It'll be days before the stone sprouts a shoot and weeks before it looks like Andy Pandy's avocado plant. Teddy thanked Looby Lou for helping him. He said he'd be back in a few weeks to see how his avocado plant was getting on. Goodbye, Looby Lou. Tiffo saw Teddy and asked him if he wanted to come to play. Not today, Tiffo. Andy Pandy had almost finished planting his avocado plant. Teddy said it looked great. He wished he could have one in his garden too, but he was going to have to wait weeks, and he wasn't very good at waiting. Andy Pandy said he knew how long it would take to grow, but in the meantime, he and Teddy could make a tree. Teddy didn't think you could make a tree, but he followed Andy Pandy anyway. Andy Pandy went to his special cupboard, and inside he found some newspaper, some sticky tape, a pair of scissors, and his paint box. Teddy still didn't think you could make a tree, and especially not out of newspaper. Andy Pandy gave two sheets of newspaper to Teddy, then showed him how to stick them together with the sticky tape. Teddy had a go, but the sticky tape was very sticky. Teddy got a bit stuck. Andy Pandy helped get him unstuck. Next time, Teddy did a bit better. Then Andy Pandy rolled up his paper. Teddy did too. Andy Pandy stuck the roll of paper so that it wouldn't unroll. Then Andy made four cuts in the paper from the top towards the middle. Then he cut Teddy's too. Teddy wasn't the most careful person with scissors. Andy Pandy pulled at the paper, and almost like magic, it began to grow and grow. The paper flopped over until it looked like a tree. Teddy wasn't quite as careful as Andy Pandy. Never mind, said Andy Pandy. Teddy would just have to be more careful next time. Teddy's next tree worked much better. Now to paint them. Later that day, Teddy raced round to invite everyone to see what he'd planted in his garden. He asked Looby Lou and Tiffo, Missy Hissy, Orby and Bilbo. Andy Pandy and Teddy had been very busy. They'd made lots of newspaper trees and they'd planted them in Teddy's garden. Everyone thought they looked just wonderful. Looby Lou brought some biscuits and lemonade that she'd made. They had quite a party. Pandy Pandy was telling Looby Loo and Teddy he'd like to have something special to stand on top of his special cupboard when he heard a strange noise. What could it be? They all went to find out. There was a strange shell on the picnic table, and Bilbo had made the noise by blowing into it. Bilbo said the strange shell was called a conch, and he whispered to Looby that Bilbo's conch would look just right on top of his special cupboard. Bilbo had found the conch on a market stall during his travels far away. He'd bought it by swapping it for a coconut. Andy and the others had never heard of a market where you could buy things by swapping them for other things. But Looby thought it would be very exciting to be at a market where you could swap interesting things. Andy said they should hold their own market on the green, so they decided to hold a market that very afternoon. Andy looked for interesting things in his special cupboard. He found a duster with holes in it. But that wasn't very interesting. There was a milk bottle with a dead flower in it. That wasn't very interesting either. But then Andy found a wooden model of a lion. That was very interesting. Andy found models of a tiger and an elephant and lots of other wild animals. He could put them all on his market stall. Looby Loo had some beautiful handkerchiefs. She'd sewn the pictures on them herself. She thought they would be very nice to have on her market stall. Before long, Andy and Looby had their stalls ready. But Teddy had taken a bit longer. He'd decided to have jars of honey on his stall. Missy Hissy had been watching Andy and his friends set up their market, but she'd never seen a market before and wanted to know what was going on. Bilbo already knew what was going on, and he was taking lumps of dried seaweed to swap for any interesting things he might find at the market. Soon the market was in full swing, and all the visitors were wondering what to buy from the stalls. Tiffo liked Teddy's jars of honey, but he hadn't brought anything to swap. So he went home to find something interesting. As soon as Bilbo saw Andy's model animals, he knew he wanted them to live on his favourite shelf. Missy Hissy loved Looby Loo's handkerchiefs. She wanted them to keep her head dry when it rained. But tying a handkerchief with her tail was very hard, so Looby had to help her. Tiffo brought Teddy a pile of old bones to swap for his jar of honey. And Missy Hissy had brought a pile of twigs to swap for Looby's handkerchiefs. Soon, almost everything had been sold, and it was time for the market to close. At first, Teddy was pleased with what he'd swapped for his honey, but he wasn't sure he really wanted Tiffo's old bones, and he was pleased when Tiffo brought his honey back. Tiffo hadn't been able to get the lid off the jar, so Teddy showed him how it was done. Then he showed Tiffo how to eat honey, and in no time, the jar was empty. Now Tiffo had somewhere to keep his old bones, so they were both happy. Looby hadn't known how to use Missy Hissy's twigs, but she'd painted them and was going to show Andy the splendid decoration she'd made for her table. Andy Pandy wondered what to do with Bilbo's seaweed when Looby came to show him her painted twigs. Andy thought they looked much better than dead seaweed, but then they heard the sound of Bilbo's conch shell. Bilbo was so pleased with the model animals from Andy's stall that he wanted to keep them all on his favourite shelf. But now he'd got no room for his conch, so he brought it for Andy as a present. The conch did look perfect on Andy's special cupboard.